Another movie marathon. We are going to do Friday the 13th. So we're going to start off with number one, obviously. And then there's part two we're going to watch. Part three, 3D. Part four, well, the final chapter. Part five, A New Beginning. Part six, Jason Lives.
We're going to have to switch the box set here because I don't have seven and eight solos.
Part 7 and 8 from the box set, The New Blood and Jason Takes Manhattan. This is the box set, very nice. And then part 9, Jason Goes to Hell, and part 10, Jason. And we are going to be doing it, me, Mike, and our dogs, Macy and Clyde.
Macy going to town.
Butters. And Bonnie. They just got ugly haircuts.
Yes, they
did. All right.
Alrighty, so Friday the 13th series franchise. We're gonna watch all 10 original films. We're gonna skip the remake because it's not part of the original series franchise, obviously. Yeah, I've got this figured out. I think it's gonna take about 15 hours. The time is, if you can see that right there, it says 6:06. So we're gonna be starting here right away. And yeah, we'll be keeping you guys updated with some foods, some treats, and you know, the films themselves, and then yeah, we'll catch you guys in a bit. Alrighty,
peace.
Alrighty, folks, here's the start of a new marathon, and this is going to be the starting eats for it. We've got three homemade pizzas here, a couple ham and pineapples, and a pepperoni, just keeping it basic. The ham and pineapples are Alfredo sauce based, and the other one is of course this regular pizza sauce. Yeah, so once these cook up, we'll come back and we're gonna get right into this. Tonight's features of Friday the 13th. Bubble cheese bubble. Oh yeah, those things are looking sexy. Alrighty, I'm gonna cut these things up, head downstairs. And we're gonna start this bitch off. Yeah. Okay. Now these things are finally cooked and cut up. We are about to start the first film in the Friday the 13th series. Yeah. And it is now 6:19, so this is gonna be the official time of start. Start time. Wow, can't talk right now. So, I guess we're gonna hit play. If I can, yes, 6:19, the marathon starts, and I believe it's definitely going to run. It's about 15 hours of movies, so, but I don't think we're going to be taking off too much tonight. We have lots of coffees and other stuff to keep us awake, so we will be mostly downstairs tonight doing this, and I guess we'll be back with you guys right after the film's done, or even during it. Maybe I'll get some clips from it. But this is Friday the 13th, Part 1, released 1980.
Thank you.
Yikes. All right. So that is the end of the original Friday the 13th. Let me volume this down a little bit. Alrighty. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've watched the original one, and I gotta say, I really enjoyed it. It's just been a long time since I've actually watched a slasher film that was shot from, the POV, the point of view of the killer throughout the whole film. It's exciting. The one issue I always had with Friday the 13th, the original movie, I thought it's shot really well. I think Sean Cunningham did a great job directing the film, but the pacing is a little slow, but, it's not really the worst thing in the world, because I think the way he spaced out the killings and stuff worked really well. I do think maybe he could have maybe cut down the end battle between Mrs. Voorhees and Alice a little bit. I mean, that battle is like 20 minutes long. It's pretty long, actually. But those are just my thoughts on the film. I absolutely love this film. It's it falls in about the middle of the pack for me in the series, but it's a great film overall. And yeah, what are your thoughts on this one?
The first time I had ever seen it, so.
The first time you've ever seen the film.
I know.
So you had no idea that Jason's mom was the killer?
No.
Don't you wish that you could go back to that and have that feeling all over again? Yeah. So we're going to be moving on to part two, and it is exactly... Oh, what time is it? I guess I could probably turn on this light. It is 7:56 at night, so we should be starting this one around 8 o'clock, and we're going to be moving on to Miners Part 2. Alrighty, check you guys in a few.
Want something to eat?
Oh yeah. Bye bye, Alice. Junk food.
Hey, so you gonna come down and get us or what? Yeah, okay, give me the dress.
How's that pepperoni?
Here, wait.
Sweet, are you excited for Friday part two?
Yes, I got my second wind, so I'm good to go now.
Second wind after the first movie. That is not good.
At 8 o'clock at night.
You know what? It's still gonna be light for a couple more hours, so hopefully it helps.
Hopefully.
All right. Yeah. So we're gonna get into this part two. Love this movie. Love Steve Miner's direction in this one. One of my favorites in the franchise. And we'll keep you guys updated with whatever comes up.
Mommy has a reward for you.
Jason, Mother is talking to you!
That's it.
Yeah, part two is over. Gotta love that movie. Love Steve Miner's direction in that one. Yeah, what can I say about part two that I haven't already said, because I've already reviewed that movie once this year on my 81 series. Any thoughts on that one?
Yeah, that one was good. It went by really fast.
Yeah. I agree. The pacing in that one just seems to work really well. Really well paced.
I thought the dog was dead.
Muffin lived. Muffin lived. Yeah, I think that the effects in the movie are really good. Amy Steele does a great job in the lead. I'm still not convinced that Jason is the strongest one in the whole franchise in this film. He's a little frail looking, but I love this movie though. It's great all around. I mean, what can I say? It's a great sequel.
Yeah.
Right. All right. So, what time is it?
9:26.
And we'll be moving on to part three shortly here. So, yeah. Any final words on that one? Just looking forward to part three.
Yeah.
Alrighty, let's do that.
Perfect.
Let's get it going. Alright, we'll be back here in a few minutes. I'm probably gonna grab a pee or something. I don't know.
Grab a pee.
Something rather. Anyways. Aw, yeah. Friday part three. I just want to say rest in peace to Richard Brooker, who recently passed away. Yes, he played Jason for you watching out there that don't know that. He was Jason in this film. And he was, he seemed like he was a really cool guy, always on the convention circuit and stuff. And so, yeah, rest in peace to Richard Brooker. There he is right there as Jason. He will be missed. He was an awesome Jason. I like Jason in this film. Like I said, I'm a big fan of this because this is the film where he gets his mask, and it's just very memorable and iconic. And we are watching this in 2D, of course. That's why the credits are like this, for, you know, because it's supposed to be in 3D. I've honestly never watched this movie in 3D before.
Why don't we? We got nice glasses.
It's red and blue ones. No. No, you can't use the ones that you get at the theater. You're funny. No, yeah, this is red and blue ones, so. But anyways, 43 right now. We will see you guys in a bit. Maybe some updates during the film. Yeah. Like, this
Where
is like.
Are you going? Hey, now cut that out right now. That's not funny.
I don't know how she didn't see that coming. Part three. Alright. So, any thoughts on that one? Now, what did you notice in this movie?
I don't know.
What did you notice?
Oh, what did you
pick out in this film?
One part with the car where they're filming, you can see the people filming. Saw that. And I want to bet, too, because I bet Mike about the girl that was killed, the pregnant one that was asking for a beer. Yeah.
Anyways. No, there's interesting, there's little quirky things with the script in this movie. The character Debbie in this movie, she says over I don't know, a few times in the film, I believe, that she's pregnant.
Just once.
No, she says it a couple times. She says it once in the vehicle, and she also says it earlier, just after that, too. But the point is that, you know, it's really pointless to have her pregnant in the film if you're just going to blatantly kill her off, like a pregnant girl. But there's a funny part where her boyfriend or the guy that she's hooking up with asks her if she wants a beer, and she accepts it. And then she dies shortly after. Maybe that's why she died right after, because she shouldn't be drinking while she's pregnant. But I thought that was a little quirky thing in the script. It's kind of pointless to have in the script. But part three, Richard Brooker as Jason, does a great job. I love this movie. I think Steve Miner did a great job directing this one. Kills are good. Now, I was reading a long time ago about the main character. I don't know what her real name is. Dana Kimmel. Chris Higgins is her character in the film. I was reading a while ago that that she had like a lot of problems with, you know, the cut of the film at the time, and she made the producers take out a bunch of excessive violence that was in it, and the gratuitous nudity and stuff, which sucks. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that a bunch of that footage is now lost. I'm pretty sure it's also, it was lost for this film. So, but I guess we'll all find that out when Crystal Lake Memories comes out. You know, the 8 or 12 hour documentary. That should be exciting. But yeah,
it's a marathon for that.
Yeah, it's a marathon in its own for sure. But yeah, part three. I'm a really big fan of this movie, man. I think it's one of my favorite ones. I love the kills. It's just a fun film, really fun film. We're going to move on to part four, which is my personal favorite in the entire franchise. But yeah, so we'll be back with part four here in a few minutes. Alrighty, check you later. Cheese, pre-melted. What is this?
Wine.
Oh, that's actually one of our bottles of wine, as you can see. Tips and Moodz. Cool.
A little bit more garlic.
Garlic is good.
Yeah. Put a little bit more.
Yo, the final chapter. Final. Friday the 13th, the final chapter. It is 11:36. We are starting part four. Directed by Joseph Zito. He also did another one of my favorite slasher films of all time, The Prowler from 1981. I love that movie. So let's get right into this one. Yes, this movie right here is, of course, starring Corey Feldman. Very young Corey Feldman. Yeah, big fan of this movie.
This is your favorite one, right?
This is my favorite one.
The fondue is cooking.
I don't want to scare anyone, but I'm going to give it to you straight about Jason. His body was never recovered from the lake after he drowned.
Aw yeah, the final chapter. Starring Kimberly Beck. And of course, Corey Feldman, who plays Tommy Jarvis in this. Crispin Glover, we all know and love him, of course, from Back to the Future. And various other horror films. Yeah, I'm a really big fan of this movie. I love the cast. I love the characters. Just a fun one, man. Really fun. And of course, this also marks the return of Tom Savini's special effects, too.
Yeah,
yeah. 11:41. We are in progress, just waiting for the fondue to heat up here. Yeah, it's getting there. Yeah, we'll be back with some updates. Cheese is bubbling. This is really good. How's it taste?
Delicious.
Awesome. Yes, we are in the middle of Friday the 13th, part 4.
Having a cheese fondue at quarter cheese after fondue. 12. Yeah,
quarter after 12 right now. Me and Pips were just talking about this movie, how this movie kind of amped up the... not only the nudity in the series, but, you know, the kills. I think this one has the most at this point in the franchise, but definitely there's a lot more nudity in this movie than the previous ones, I think, put together. But, yeah, we'll be back with our thoughts at the end of this. Just going to enjoy some of this bubbly Swiss here.
If it gets too bad out there.
Oh, yeah.
Screw you, Paul.
Drinking my water out of a Friday the 13th cup. Okay. Oh yeah, Tommy's going fucking nuts. Alright, that was the final chapter. Part 4. Thoughts on that one?
I like the kill, actually, when that girl came out of the house to leave and she's like, ah, slut. Then she goes to hop on your bike and you can see the kill from the lightning on the house. I thought that was kind of cool.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome. Yeah. I think one of my favorite moments, not favorite moments in the film, but I like when Jason throws the, what's his name? Rob? Was his name Rob? I guess he was the stray hitchhiker that they picked up through the window at the end. That shit was fucking nuts. Yeah. Just how hard he throws him through the window. Yeah. That's pretty awesome. That movie's got... they definitely amped up the everything in the series up to that point. The kills were the highest at that point in the series. The nudity level was definitely the highest. And then that brings us into part 5, which just takes it to a different level. And then so on, but... yeah, part 4 has always been my favorite one. I don't know. I like the characters. I like Crispin Glover, you know. Am I a dead fuck? I just like how he's so concerned. It's funny. I don't know. They're likable, I guess. Jason's badass in this film, man. Something about him in this one, he's crazy. But, yeah. Part 4 done. Moving on to part 5. It is officially 1:07 in the morning. And we are still rolling. We've polished off this this cheese fondue here. And I am just still drinking a little bit of water out of my Friday the 13th glass. Yeah. And I guess we'll be back here in a few minutes with part 5. Looking forward to watching part 5 quite a bit, actually. It's one I don't watch a lot. So I'm pretty stoked to watch it. It's been a long time. It's always the one I skip. I always go from 4 to 6 every time I'm watching these movies. I never usually watch all these in a row, but I do skip 5 a lot, though. Anyways, coming back at you. Alright, what are we going for here? I'm thinking... let's go with the Coconut Island. Coconut Island. Alright, got my coffee. Yeah. Walking back downstairs. Friday the 13th. Alright. Alright.
got my bowl full of candies. So I'm getting a little sleepy.
Nice. That's not good. That's not good. It's only 1:15 in the morning. All right. On that note, 1:15 a.m., part 5 is queued up. And that's right. This is a new beginning. Because the final chapter means absolute shit in the Friday the 13th series. That's right. Part 5. This is a unique one. Kind of stands out. For fans of the franchise, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And of course, the wife has never seen this one, so I'm not going to say anything. You know, like I said, it's been a while since I've seen this one. Is a good beginning. No pun intended. I like the way they did that. That's awesome. You excited for this one?
I am, yeah.
Yeah. Keep munching on all those chocolates over there. Keep yourself awake. Even Macy's not even tired. Alright, so yeah. Part 5 officially starting here, but 1:22. It is a few minutes into it. And we will keep you guys posted throughout this. I'm pretty excited to actually watch this movie. I know it has a lot of kills. Yeah. All right, let's do this. So I do highly recommend the Orville Redenbacher White Cheddar Chipotle. Mmm, very tasty. And back to the movie. How do you feel about Jason not being the killer in that one?
Well, I missed some of it because I fell asleep.
Yes, unfortunately, you did miss some of that movie, didn't you?
I didn't miss the end.
I could tell by the snores in my right ear. This was never one of my favorite ones in the series, but you know, watching again, it's actually pretty enjoyable. You know, it feels just like a, you know, a regular Friday film. Once it's revealed that, you know, the killer isn't Jason in this, spoiler alert, I'm sure everyone watching this has seen this movie before, but, you know what, there's enough kills, there's enough action in this film to keep it going, or to be, you know, super enjoyable. I really enjoy this film, actually, it's pretty fun. I just wish that there was a little more, you know, a little more gore in the kills. They do cut out quite a bit. You can tell this movie has just been butchered, but I don't know if there's, like, an uncut version somewhere sitting in a vault of this one, but, you know, it would be nice to see sometime. But, yeah, I like the fact that, you know, I like the Tommy Jarvis character. I think it's pretty fun. And, yeah, so I guess we're going to be moving on to part six, which is an awesome, awesome film. It is 2:47 in the morning right now as we finish part five. How you feeling?
Good now.
Yeah? You a little rejuvenated?
I got my third wind.
Yeah? Do you need a coffee?
I don't know. Coffee seems to put me to sleep.
Yeah, that's a really weird thing. I definitely need a refill on my water, though. And I'll probably actually get a coffee here maybe sometime during this film. But yeah, anyways, I'll be back here in a couple minutes. Yeah. Alright, it's about that time for Friday the 13th, part 6, Jason Lives. It is approximately 2:52 a.m. right now. Let's get this party started. Yeah, I really enjoy this movie. I think this one's fantastic. It's got great kills. I've always thought that this one is kind of a little different. It seems like it takes place in a little more settings than the usual films, but always been a big fan of this one. Really enjoy this film. How you feeling? How's that popcorn taste in there?
Good.
That's good. Need some energy here. Yeah. Get through this. I do. Shouldn't be too hard. This is a fun one. Yeah, Jason 6, Jason Lives. I love this one. This one's got fantastic kills. Definitely a lot better than part 5 for kills. I'm pretty stoked on this one. One of my favorites in the series. This is how we do it. It's officially just after 3 a.m. in the morning. Should be done roughly 4:30. Just enjoying some hell of a good dip. This is buffalo wing dip, fantastic, with just some plain regular Ruffles. It is a great combination. I highly recommend it. And of course, I'm drinking some water out of the Friday the 13th glass. Pretty gangster. How's the popcorn treating you still?
Good.
That's good.
Hey, butter. Say hi.
Touch you, please.
Anyways.
You sure know how to make an entrance?
Be back in a little bit. Oh yeah, part 6, Jason Lives. Such an awesome movie. Jason is fucking badass in that movie, man. Love it. Tom Matthews does a great job in that movie. Your thoughts?
I really like that one.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah.
Great kills. Honestly, one of my favorite.
And it was, like, tied into the other one, and I knew who he was the whole time, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting that Tommy Jarvis is played by three different people in three different movies, but, What do you do? Yeah, fantastic kills in that one. Most memorable kills probably when Jason kills the cop, breaks him in half backwards. Fucking love that. That's just awesome shit right there. Yeah, just a really good film. I love the scene in the movie when Jason stabs the young kid or the young boy or whatever in the head while he's driving, and they fucking flip the RV. I think that's badass. And then after Jason climbs out of it, he's standing on top. I think that's just killer, man. So cool. Yeah, definitely one of my more favorite ones in the series. Everything, it has everything going for it. But yeah, so it is about 20 after 4 in the morning, and I'm not even getting tired yet, so this is going to be very easy for me to finish. How you feeling?
I'm feeling better.
Yeah?
Yeah. I didn't fall asleep at all in this one, so.
Cool.
Good, yeah.
Cool. So gonna take probably a 5-minute or here. Gonna go grab another pee break here.
Yeah.
Probably gonna make a coffee right now.
Coconut coffee.
Yeah, I'll make a coffee right now, and we'll be back with part 7. Probably within the next 10 minutes. Gotta let these doggies outside too, so. Yeah. Another thing I love about this movie, it just reminded me, is the soundtrack, all the Alice Cooper songs. Fantastic. Anyways, on that note, we'll be back in a few minutes. Alright, it's exactly 4:30 in the morning. We are moving on to Friday the 13th, part 7, The New Blood. Let me press play here. This is... Yeah, I had to pop in the disc from the box set. But that's okay. Same shit, right? Yeah, part 7. I'm a really big fan. This movie actually has my favorite kill in the entire series in it. I know this one got a lot of mixed reviews when it first came out because of, you know, the whole telekinesis thing, but hey, it's enjoyable. Coffee tasting.
Awesome. Got my San Francisco cup.
Yeah, nice. I got myself a new cup also. I think this is like number 4 of the night too.
I'm on number 2.
Number 2? Wow. But you've also had like 3 pops.
2. I'm 2 pops.
All right. Here we go. Friday the 13th, part 7. The New Blood. Yeah, I don't know, man. I really enjoy this one. I think this is quite a good episode. Or quite a good episode. Quite a good sequel. Yeah. But, 4:35 should be done around 6 a.m. Moving along here. Keeping it real. Still munching on the Orville Redenbacher. This stuff's really good. Got the bowl of goodies here. Coffee. Let's get this party started here. Next one. That one's pretty awesome, though, too. this one right here.
Okay, you big hunk of a man, come and get me.
Okay. Yes, my favorite kill in the entire series. I never laughed so fucking hard in a movie in my life. I'm laughing that hard at that? Oh yeah. The New Blood Part 7. I like that movie. I really enjoy the movie. I think the ending is a little cheesy, but yeah, what can you do? There's some pretty damn good kills in there. I would just really like to see them put the footage that they cut out back into this film. Put those deleted scenes in there. Make those kills a little more spruced up. But yeah. So how'd you, what'd you feel? How'd you like that one? Sleepyhead?
I know.
Not doing too good on this one, are you?
I know, I'm not near as good as last time.
So it is 6 a.m. We've been going for, well, I've been going for about 12 hours now. Yeah, so I'm thinking I might just, whoops. That. I guess I could probably just do this right in one shot here, Kent, right? Since it's on the same disc, I'll just go over to part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. I like this movie. I gotta say, man, part 7, the first movie that Kane Hodder did, just, he's fucking badass as Jason, man. He really is. You know, watching the first 7 movies and comparing all the Jasons, I gotta say, Kane Hodder is just amazing. And the guy that plays Jason in part 6 is really good too. I think it's CJ Graham. I think that's what his name is. Yeah, he was really good too. But Kane Hodder's just so big and vicious, and I like the kill in part 7 when I think it's the last girl that he kills when he breaks through the front door and puts that axe in her head and then throws her over the TV. Fucking vicious, man. Real vicious. But anyways, we're going to move right along here. Might as well start part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. Now, I remember when this first came out, I think it was 1988, I believe it was. Man, this movie got shit on. Real fucking bad. I actually really like this movie, to be honest. It's weird because, it's not all taking place in Crystal Lake. It's obviously goes to Manhattan, and you got Kane Hodder in Times Square. Very odd. But yeah. We're gonna get this going.
It's like this. We live in claustrophobia. A land of steel and concrete. Trapped by dark waters. There is no escape. Nor do we want it. We've come to thrive on it. And each other. You can't get the adrenaline.
Ah, yeah, here we go. This movie has a really, really 80s vibe to it.
I love this town.
It's got that dirty New York look from the 80s in it. Music's really, really fucking 80s. I enjoy it for what it is. I know the subway scenes in this movie were filmed actually in Vancouver, BC. Alright. So I'll be back. Maybe some updates. This one should be done around 7:30 in the morning. I might pop in before then.
Good now.
You're good now. Alright. This song kicks ass. This makes the movie right here.
Startup.
Yup.
Forget about it, Susie. They're just stories.
Liquid yogurt. Does a body good at 6 o'clock in the morning. Yeah.
Yo.
Friday. Friday the 13th, Part 8. Jason Takes Manhattan. Over. You know, it's not a great movie by any means, but it's entertaining. The thing that annoys me about this movie is that there's like no likable characters except for, you know, the two survivors. Everybody else in this movie really sucks. The teacher in this film is just, oh, you just can't wait till he dies. It's just so bad. This movie really did suffer from, you know, budget restraints. It was pretty much all filmed in Vancouver. Originally was supposed to be all shot in New York. A little bit on the boat and mostly take place in New York, but due to budget restraints, they had to film pretty much everything in Vancouver and do mostly the boat. So, it's kind of why this one turned out how it did, but it is what it is. It's not the worst in the franchise, but it's not so bad. Kane Hodder kicks ass in this movie, as usual. He just, every time he kills someone, every time he walks, every time he breathes, you know, it's just it's very noticeable. It's tough. So, do you got any words on that one, Sleepyhead?
It was cool to see New York because we're going to be there next week. Thursday, and the dog
looked
like our dog, so yeah, it was cool.
Yes, Toby in the movie looks exactly like Macy, minus the bandana. So it is 7:37 a.m. in the morning. I've been officially going for 13 hours now, just over 13 hours. And I've got two more movies to go, so this is a true marathon. I'm still doing pretty good. I don't think Pips is doing that good. But yeah, I'll be back here in a few minutes for the startup of Jason Goes to Hell, which is my least favorite one in the entire franchise, original franchise. Alright, I'll check you guys in a minute. Alright, Jason Goes to Hell. Part 9, 7:39, so that's only 2 minutes later. We're going to get right into this. Why waste time? It's a marathon. I want to play the rated version. Yeah, right. Unrated, we go. This movie has always been my least favorite. It's due to the fact of, you know, the body jumping. It's not really a true Jason in this movie until, I guess, kind of the end. This is a weird movie. I've always thought this was just the strangest one in the franchise. I will admit, though, there is some pretty decent kills in this movie, and there's a lot. I know the body count's really ridiculously high in this one. But, you know, that's really all, you know, it has going for me anyways, but I don't know. We'll see how this turns out at, 28-8. In the morning. Sean Cunningham, the director of Part 1. What that joke was. Alright. Jason Goes to Hell Part 9. The final Friday? I think not. Yeah, the opening scene in this movie is absolutely hilarious. It's ridiculous. But, yeah, 10 to 8. See you guys in a bit. This is part 9. Yeah. Jason Goes to Hell, Part 9, at 9:08 in the morning. This has been a long one. Yeah, that movie's just... I just don't get any enjoyment out of that movie. It's just one of those movies that... I don't know, the kills are okay, but it's the storyline's so outrageously full of plot holes and just ridiculous and... I don't know. Alright, I'm going to move on to Jason 10 and call her a marathon. I'll be back in a few minutes. Alright, so this is going to do it. Jason 10. It's officially 9:10 in the morning. That's kind of fitting. So it looks like I'm going to be done just after 9 or 10:30. Yeah. I know you didn't catch much of that last one there, did you? So that's pretty much going to do it. I'm going to press play here on Jason 10. I haven't watched this one in a long time. All I remember is this one having a really high body count. The awesome face smashing scene. Being weirded out that Jason was like hiding bodies and stuff in this. I thought it was pretty weird, but yeah, it's been a while since I've watched this. Jason 10 in space. Finishing off the marathon. If you guys are still watching this, I applaud you. Thank you for getting this far. It's amazing I'm still going. Yeah, been going for 15 hours on this marathon. That's not bad. It's not bad. I'm tired. I'll admit, I am tired now. That Jason Goes to Hell takes it out of me, man. I kind of suffer in that one all the time. Still to this day, I cannot believe this movie got made. Jason 10. Jason X. Uber Jason in space. I will be back at the end of the movie to say goodbye. Oh yeah. Jason 10, over. That is a chore to get through. I am not a fan of that movie. That movie is... it's just really, really bad. Just really bad. So that's going to do it. 17 hours. 17 hours that marathon took. That was fun. That was really fun. Yeah.
You did it?
Yeah, I did it.
I lacked a little bit this time. Not as good as last time.
You definitely slept through a little bit there. I can't believe I made it through this, especially with Jason Goes to Hell and Jason 10. My two least favorite films in the franchise, of course, right at the end of the marathon. Yeah.
Until next time.
Until next time. Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what marathon we're going to do next, but if you're still watching this, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. And, yeah, like I said, till next time.
Time for bed now.
I agree. Time for bed. Peace out, homies.
Listen, Donna, I know that you're supposed to
have that as your girlfriend. So it is about 20 after 4 in the morning, and I'm not even getting tired yet, so this is going to be very easy for me to finish. How you feeling?
I'm feeling better.
Yeah?
Yeah. I didn't fall asleep at all in this one, so.
Cool.
Good, yeah.
Cool. So gonna take probably a 5-minute here. Gonna go grab another pee break here.
Yeah.
Probably gonna make a coffee right now.
Coconut coffee.
Yeah, I'll make a coffee right now, and we'll be back with part 7. Probably within the next 10 minutes. Gotta let these doggies outside too, so. Yeah. Another thing I love about this movie, it just reminded me, is the soundtrack, all the Alice Cooper songs. Fantastic. Anyways, on that note, we'll be back in a few minutes. Alright, it's exactly 4:30 in the morning. We are moving on to Friday the 13th, part 7, The New Blood. Let me press play here. This is. Yeah, I had to pop in the disc from the box set. But that's okay. Same shit, right? Yeah, part 7. I'm a really big fan. This movie actually has my favorite kill in the entire series in it. I know this one got a lot of mixed reviews when it first came out because of, you know, the whole telekinesis thing, but hey, it's enjoyable.
There's a legend round here. A killer buried. But not dead. A curse on Crystal Lake.
How's the coffee tasting?
Awesome. Got my San Francisco cup.
Yeah, nice. I got myself a new cup also. I think this is like number 4 of the night too.
Mm-hmm. I'm on number 2.
Number 2?
He's down there.
Wow. But you've also had like 3 pops.
2. I'm...
Alright, here we go. Friday the 13th, part 7. The New Blood. Yeah, I don't know, man. I really enjoy this one. I think this is quite a good episode. Sequel. Yeah. But, 4:35 should be done around 6 a.m. Moving along here. Keeping it real. Still munching on the Orville Redenbacher. This stuff's really good. Got the bowl of goodies here. Coffee. Let's get this party started here. Next one. That one's pretty awesome, though, too. This one right here.
Okay, you big hunk of a man, come and get me!
Okay. Yes, my favorite kill in the entire series. I never laughed so fucking hard in a movie in my life.
Doing.
I just... Is it bad that I'm laughing that hard at that?
Oh, yeah. The New Blood, Part 7. I like that movie. I really enjoy the movie. I think the ending is a little cheesy, but... yeah, what can you do? There's some pretty damn good kills in there. I would just really like to see them put the footage that they cut out back into this film. Put those deleted scenes in there. Make those kills a little more spruced up. But yeah. So how'd you, what'd you feel? How'd you like that one? Sleepyhead?
I know.
Not doing too good on this one, are you?
I know, I'm not near as good as last time.
So it is 6 a.m. We've been going for, well, I've been going for about 12 hours now. Yeah, so I'm thinking I might just, whoops, do that. I guess I could probably just do this right in one shot here, can't, right? Since it's on the same disc, I'll just go over to part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. I like this movie. I gotta say, man, part 7, the first movie that Kane Hodder did, just, he's fucking badass as Jason, man. He really is. You know, watching the first 7 movies and comparing all the Jasons, I gotta say, Kane Hodder is just amazing. And the guy that plays Jason in part 6 is really good, too. I think it's CJ Graham. I think that's what his name is. Yeah, he was really good, too. But Kane Hodder's just so big and vicious, and I like the kill in part 7 when... I think it's the last girl that he kills when he breaks through the front door and puts that axe in her head and then throws her over the TV. Fucking vicious, man. Real vicious. But anyways, we're going to move right along here. Might as well start part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. Now, I remember when this first came out, I think it was 1988, I believe it was. Man, this movie got shit on. Real fucking bad. I actually really like this movie, to be honest. It's weird because it's not all taking place in Crystal Lake. It's obviously goes to Manhattan, and you got Kane Hodder in Times Square. Very odd. But yeah, we're gonna get this going.
There is no escape, nor do we want it. We've come to thrive on it, and each other. You can't get the adrenaline.
Ah, yeah, here we go. This movie has a really, really 80s vibe to it.
I love this town.
It's got that dirty New York look from the 80s in it. Music's really, really fucking 80s. I enjoy it for what it is. I know the subway scenes in this movie were filmed... actually in Vancouver, B.C. Alright. So I'll be back. Maybe some updates. This one should be done around 7:30 in the morning. I might pop in before then.
Good now.
You're good now. Alright. This song kicks ass. This makes the movie right here. Yawp.
Another movie marathon. We are going to do Friday the 13th. So we're going to start off with number one, obviously. And then there's part two we're going to watch. Part three, 3D. Part four, well, the final chapter. Part five, A New Beginning. Part six, Jason Lives.
We're going to have to switch the box set here because I don't have 7 and 8 solos.
Part 7 and 8 from the box set, The New Blood, and Jason Takes Manhattan. This is the box set, very nice. And then Part 9, Jason Goes to Hell, and part 10, Jason. And we are going to be doing it, me, Mike, and our dogs, Macy and Clyde.
Macy going to town.
Butters. And Bonnie. They just got ugly haircuts.
Yes, they
did. All right.
Alrighty, so Friday the 13th series franchise. We're going to watch all 10 original films. We're going to skip the remake because it's not part of the original series franchise, obviously. Yeah, I've got this figured out. I think it's going to take about 15 hours. The time is, if you can see that right there, it says 6:06, so we're going to be starting here right away. And yeah, we'll be keeping you guys updated with some foods, some treats, and, you know, the films themselves, and then, yeah, we'll catch you guys in a bit. Alrighty.
Peace.
Alrighty, folks. Here's the start of a new marathon, and this is going to be the starting eats for it. We've got three homemade pizzas here, a couple ham and pineapples, and a pepperoni, just keeping it basic. The ham and pineapples are Alfredo sauce based, and the other one is, of course, this regular pizza sauce. Yeah, so once these cook up, we'll come back and we're gonna get right into this. Tonight's features of, yeah, Friday the 13th. Bubble cheese bubble. Oh, yeah, those things are looking sexy. Alrighty, I'm gonna cut these things up, head downstairs. And we're gonna start this bitch off. You. Yeah. Okay. Now these things are finally cooked and cut up. We are about to start the first film in the Friday the 13th series. Yeah. And it is now 6:19, so this is gonna be the official time of start. Start time. Wow, can't talk right now. So, I guess we're gonna hit play. If I can, yes, 6:19, the marathon starts, and I believe it's definitely going to run. It's about 15 hours of movies, so, but I don't think we're going to be taking off too much tonight. We have lots of coffees and other stuff to keep us awake, so we will be mostly downstairs tonight doing this, and I guess we'll be back with you guys right after the film's done, or even during it. Maybe I'll get some clips from it. But this is Friday the 13th, Part 1, released 1980. Of the original Friday the 13th. Wait, volume is down a little bit. Alrighty. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've watched the original one, and I gotta say, I really enjoyed it. It's just been a long time since I've actually watched a slasher film that was shot from, you know, the POV, the point of view of the killer throughout the whole film. It's exciting. The one issue I always had with Friday the 13th the original movie. It's, you know, it's I thought it's shot really well. I think Sean Cunningham did a great job directing the film, but the pacing is a little slow, but, you know, it's not really the worst thing in the world, because I think the way he spaced out the killings and stuff worked really well. I do think maybe he could have probably, you know, maybe cut down the end battle between Mrs. Voorhees and Alice a little bit. I mean, that battle is like 20 minutes long. It's pretty long, actually. But those are just my thoughts on the film. I absolutely love this film. It's it falls in about the middle of the pack for me in the series, but it's a great film overall. And yeah, what are your thoughts on this one?
The first time I had ever seen it, so.
The first time you've ever seen the film.
I know.
So you had no idea that Jason's mom was the killer?
No.
Don't you wish that you could go back to that and have that feeling all over again? Yeah. So we're going to be moving on to part two, and it is exactly... Oh, what time is it? I guess I could probably turn on this light. It is 7:56 at night, so we should be starting this one around 8 o'clock, and we're going to be moving on to Miners Part 2. Alrighty, check you guys in a few.
You want something to eat?
Oh yeah. Bye bye, Alice. Junk food.
Hey, so you gonna come down and get us or what? Yeah, okay, give me the dress.
How's that pepperoni?
Here, wait,
yummy.
Wait.
Sweet, are you excited for Friday part two?
Yes, I got my second wind, so I'm good to go now.
Second wind after the first movie. That is not good.
At 8 o'clock at night.
You know what? It's still gonna be light for a couple more hours, so hopefully it helps.
Hopefully.
All right.
Yeah. So we're gonna get into this part two. Love this movie. Love Steve Miner's direction in this one. One of my favorites in the franchise. And we'll keep you guys updated with what... directed by Joseph Zito. He also did another one of my favorite slasher films of all time, The Prowler from 1981. I love that movie. So let's get right into this one. Yes, this movie right here is, of course, starring Corey Feldman. Very young Corey Feldman. Yeah, big fan of this movie.
This is your favorite one, right?
This is my favorite one.
The fondue is cooking.
I don't want to scare anyone, but I'm going to give it to you straight about Jason. His body was never recovered from the lake after he drowned.
Aw yeah, the final chapter. Starring Kimberly Beck. And of course, Corey Feldman, who plays Tommy Jarvis in this. Crispin Glover, we all know and love him, of course, from Back to the Future, and various other horror films. Yeah, I'm a really big fan of this movie. I love the cast, I love the characters. Just a fun one, man. Really fun. And of course, this also marks the return of Tom Savini's special effects, too.
Hey,
So yeah, 11:41. We are in progress, just waiting for the fondue to heat up here. Yeah, it's getting there. Yeah, we'll be back with some updates. Cheese is bubbling. This is really good. How's it taste?
Delicious.
Awesome. Yes, we are in the middle of Friday the 13th, part 4.
Having a cheese fondue at quarter cheese fondue. After 12. Yeah,
quarter after 12 right now. Me and Pips were just talking about this movie, how this movie kind of amped up the... Not only the nudity in the series, but, you know, the kills. I think this one has the most at this point in the franchise, but definitely there's a lot more nudity in this movie than the previous ones, I think, put together. But, yeah, we'll be back with our thoughts at the end of this. Just going to enjoy some of this bubbly Swiss here.
It's too bad out there.
Oh, yeah.
Screw you, Paul.
Give me a few minutes.
Drinking my water out of a Friday the 13th cup. Okay. Oh yeah. Tommy's going fucking nuts. Alright, that was the final chapter. Part 4. Thoughts on that one?
I like the kill, actually, when that girl came out of the house to leave and she's like, ah, slut. Then she goes to hop on your bike and you can see the kill from the lightning on the house. I thought that was kind of cool.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome. Yeah. I think one of my favorite moments, not favorite moments in the film, but I like when Jason throws the, what's his name? Rob? Was his name Rob? I guess he was the stray hitchhiker that they picked up through the window at the end. That shit was fucking nuts. Yeah. Just how hard he throws him through the window. Yeah. That's pretty awesome. That movie's got... They definitely amped up the everything in the series up to that point. The kills were the highest at that point in the series. The nudity level was definitely the highest. And then that brings us into part 5, which just takes it to a different level. And then so on, but... Yeah, part 4 has always been my favorite one. I don't know. I like the characters. I like Crispin Glover, you know. Am I a dead fuck? I just like how he's so concerned. It's funny. I don't know. They're likable, I guess. Jason's badass in this film, man. He just... Something about him in this one, he's just fucking... He's crazy. But, yeah. Part 4 done. Moving on to part 5. It is officially 1:07 in the morning. And we are still rolling. We've polished off this this cheese fondue here. And I am just still drinking a little bit of water out of my Friday the 13th glass. Yeah. And I guess we'll be back here in a few minutes with part 5. Looking forward to watching part 5 quite a bit, actually. It's one I don't watch a lot. So I'm pretty stoked to watch it. It's been a long time. It's always the one I skip. I always go from 4 to 6 every time I'm watching these movies. I never usually watch all these in a row, but I do skip 5 a lot, though. Anyways, coming back at you. All right, what are we going for here? I'm thinking... Let's go with the Coconut Island. Coconut Island. Alright, got my coffee. Yeah. Walking back downstairs. Friday the 13th. Alright. Alright.
got my bowl full of candy, so I'm getting a little sleepy.
Nice. That's not good. That's not good. It's only 1:15 in the morning. All right, on that note, 1:15 a.m., part 5 is queued up. And that's right, this is a new beginning. Because the final chapter means absolute shit in the Friday the 13th series. That's right, part 5. This is a unique one. Kind of stands out. For fans of the franchise, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And of course, the wife has never seen this one, so I'm not going to say anything. You know, like I said, it's been a while since I've seen this one. Two is over. Gotta love that movie. Love Steve Miner's direction in that one. Yeah. What can I say about part two that I haven't already said, because I've already reviewed that movie once this year on my 81 series. Any thoughts on that one?
Yeah, that one was good. It went by really fast.
Yeah. I agree, the pacing in that one just seems to work really well. Really well paced.
I thought the dog was dead.
Muffin lived. Muffin lived. I think that the effects in the movie are really good. Amy Steele does a great job in the lead. I'm still not convinced that Jason is the strongest one in the whole franchise in this film. He's a little frail looking, but I love this movie though. It's great all around. I mean, what can I say? It's a great sequel.
Yeah.
Right. All right. So, what time is it?
9:26.
And we'll be moving on to part 3 shortly here. So, yeah. Any final words on that one? Just looking forward to part 3.
Yeah.
Alrighty, yeah. Let's do that.
Perfect.
Let's get it going. Alright, we'll be back here in a few minutes. I'm probably going to grab a pee or something. I don't know.
Grab a pee.
Something rather. Anyways. Aw, yeah. Friday Part 3. I just want to say rest in peace to Richard Brooker, who recently passed away. Yes, he played Jason for you watching out there that don't know that. He was Jason in this film. And he was, he seemed like he was a really cool guy, always on the convention circuit and stuff. And so, yeah, rest in peace to Richard Brooker. There he is right there as Jason. He will be missed. He was an awesome Jason. I like Jason in this film. Like I said, I'm a big fan of this because this is the film where he gets his mask, and it's just very memorable and iconic. And we are watching this in 2D, of course. That's why the credits are like this for, you know, because it's supposed to be in 3D. I've honestly never watched this movie in 3D before.
Why don't we? We got nice glasses.
It's red and blue ones. No. No, you can't use the ones that you get at the theater. You're funny. No, yeah, this is red and blue ones, so. But anyways, 43 right now. We will see you guys in a bit. Maybe some updates during the film. Yeah. Like, this
what
is like...
Doing? Hey, now cut that out right now. That's not funny!
I don't know how she didn't see that coming. Part 3. Alright. So, any thoughts on that one? Now, what did you notice in this movie?
I don't know.
What did you notice?
What did
you pick out in this film?
One part with the car where they're filming. You can see the people filming. Saw that. And... I want to bet, too, because I bet Mike about the girl that was killed, the pregnant one that was asking for a beer. Yeah.
Anyways. No, there's interesting, there's little quirky things with the script in this movie. The character Debbie in this movie, she says over, I don't know, a few times in the film, I believe, that she's pregnant.
Just once.
No, she says it a couple times. She says it once in the vehicle, and she also says it earlier, just after that, too. But the point is that, you know, it's really pointless to have her pregnant in the film if you're just going to blatantly kill her off, like a pregnant girl. But there's a funny part where her boyfriend or the guy that she's hooking up with asks her if she wants a beer, and she accepts it. And then she dies shortly after. Maybe that's why she died right after, because she shouldn't be drinking while she's pregnant. But I thought that was a little quirky thing in the script. It's kind of pointless to have in the script, but... part 3, Richard Brooker as Jason. Does a great job. I love this movie. I think Steve Miner did a great job directing this one. Kills are good. Now, I was reading a long time ago about the main character. I don't know what her real name is. Dana Kimmel. Chris Higgins is her character in the film. I was reading a while ago that she had like a lot of problems with, you know, the cut of the film at the time, and she made the producers take out a bunch of excessive violence that was in it, and the gratuitous nudity and stuff, which sucks. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that a bunch of that footage is now lost. I'm pretty sure it's also it was lost for this film. So. But I guess we'll all find that out when Crystal Lake Memories comes out. You know, the 8 or 12 hour documentary. That should be exciting. But yeah.
It's a marathon for that.
Yeah, it's a marathon in its own for sure. But yeah, part 3. I'm a really big fan of this movie, man. I think it's one of my favorite ones. I love the kills. It's just a fun film. Really fun film. We're going to move on to part 4. Which is my personal favorite in the entire franchise. But yeah, so we'll be back with part four here in a few minutes. Alrighty, check you later.
Cheese. Pre-melted.
What is this?
Wine.
Oh, yeah, it's actually one of our bottles of wine, as you can see. Tips and Moodz. Cool.
A little bit more garlic.
Garlic is good.
Yeah. Put a little bit more.
Yo, the final chapter. Final. Friday the 13th, the final chapter. It is 11:36. We are starting part four. That is a good beginning. No pun intended. I like the way they did that. That's awesome. You excited for this one?
I am, yeah.
Yeah. Keep munching on all those chocolates over there. Keep yourself awake. Even Macy's not even tired. All right. So, yeah. Part five officially starting here, but 1:22. It is a few minutes into it. And we will keep you guys posted throughout this. I'm pretty excited to actually watch this movie. I know it has a lot of kills. Yeah. All right, let's do this. So I do highly recommend the Orville Redenbacher White Cheddar Chipotle. Very tasty. And back to the movie. How do you feel about Jason not being the killer in that one?
Well, I missed some of it because I fell asleep.
Yes, unfortunately, you did miss some of that movie, didn't you?
I didn't miss the end.
I could tell by the snores in my right ear. this was never one of my favorite ones in the series, but, you know, watching again, it's actually pretty enjoyable. You know, it feels just like a regular Friday film. Once it's revealed that, you know, the killer isn't Jason in this, spoiler alert, I'm sure everyone watching this has seen this movie before, but, you know what, there's enough kills, there's enough action in this film to keep it going, or to be, you know, super enjoyable. I really enjoy this film, actually. It's pretty fun. I just wish that there was a little more gore in the kills. They do cut out quite a bit. You can tell this movie has just been butchered, but I don't know if there's like an uncut version somewhere sitting in a vault of this one, but you know, it would be nice to see sometime. But yeah, I like the fact that, you know, I like the Tommy Jarvis character. I think it's pretty fun. And Yeah, so I guess we're going to be moving on to part six, which is an awesome, awesome film. It is 2:47 in the morning right now as we finish part five. How you feeling?
Good now.
Yeah? You a little rejuvenated?
I got my third wind.
Yeah? Do you need a coffee?
I don't know. Coffee seems to put me to sleep.
Yeah, that's a really weird thing. I definitely need a refill on my water, though. And I'll probably actually get a coffee here maybe sometime during this film. But yeah. Anyways, I'll be back here in a couple minutes. Yeah. Alright, it's about that time for Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives. It is approximately 2:52 a.m. right now. Let's get this party started. Yeah, I really enjoy this movie. I think this one's fantastic. It's got great kills. I've always thought that this one is kind of a little different. It seems like it takes place in a little more settings than the usual films, but always been a big fan of this one. Really enjoy this film. How you feeling? How's that popcorn taste in there?
Good.
That's good. Need some energy here. Yeah. Get through this. I do. Shouldn't be too hard. This is a fun one. Yeah. Jason 6, Jason Lives. I love this one. This one's got fantastic kills. Definitely a lot better than part 5 for kills. I'm pretty stoked on this one. One of my favorites in the series. This is how we do it. It's officially just after 3 a.m. in the morning. Should be done roughly 4:30. Just enjoying some hell of a good dip. This is buffalo wing dip, fantastic, with just some plain regular Ruffles. It is a great combination. I highly recommend it. And of course, I'm drinking some water out of the Friday the 13th glass. Pretty gangster. How's the popcorn treating you still?
Good.
That's good.
Hey, Butters. Say hi.
I got you, please.
Anyways.
Yeah.
Be back in a little bit. Oh yeah. Part 6. Jason Lives. Such an awesome movie. Jason is fucking badass in that movie, man. Love it. Tom Matthews does a great job in that movie. Your thoughts?
I really like that one.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah.
Great kills. Honestly, one of my favorite.
It was, like, tied into the other one, and the guy knew who he was the whole time. Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting that Tommy Jarvis is played by three different people in three different movies, but yeah, what do you do? Yeah, fantastic kills in that one. Most memorable kills probably when Jason kills the cop, breaks him in half backwards. Fucking love that. That's just awesome shit right there. Yeah, just a really good film. I love the scene in the movie when Jason stabs the young kid or the young boy or whatever in the head while he's driving, and they fucking flip the RV. I think that's badass. And then after Jason climbs out of it, and he's standing on top. I think that's just killer, man. So cool. Yeah, definitely one of my more favorite ones in the series. Everything, it has everything going for it. But yeah.